They're great.
If you weren't my father.
Go ahead. I give you leave. We'll find two bullets in him. One of them's mine. He was hurting worse than he could stand. Had a handgun that I didn't see. Any more questions you want to ask?
No. I guess you're telling the truth. I guess if you weren't, you wouldn't ever brought him here.
He handed me you guys as a present, a regular Easter basket. And they told me to get you into some kind of shape so you could handle a little piece of this war. And that's what I'm gonna do. And that means I'm gonna tell you what to do every day and every minute of every day. I'm gonna tell you how to button your buttons. I'll even tell you when to blow your noses. And if you do something I don't like, I'm gonna jump. And when I land, it'll hurt. I'm gonna ride you till you can't stand up. But when you do stand up, you're gonna be Marines.
However, this here court may be willing to suspend that sentence indefinite, providing you sign this here paper, yielding your godson to the marshal and Mrs. Sweet. And furthermore, providing that you never again set foot in the township of Welcome, territory of Arizona.
You can throw the book at me, Judge. I ain't gonna do her. I ain't breaking my promise to a dying woman.
Pony soldiers are near. Soon will be fought a remembered fight. They will come here first. You will not go with them, white man.
I will not.
Lead our pony soldiers will question you. You will say you have seen Apache trailing to the west.
This I won't do.
You will not?
I will not.
You have good men. Treasure him.
Yes, he don't like anybody behind him. Neither do I.
Perhaps the law doesn't quite see it my way. Since when did hired guns get choosy? You're paid to take...
I'm paid to risk my neck. And I'll decide where and when I'll do it. This isn't it. Just for the record, what are you paying?
Top money. $25 a head.
Last month it was $35.
But this month it's $25 a head.
Well, these gentlemen have offered to take the whole barrel sight unseen. Is that correct?
That's correct, Mr. Thomas.
And what's your top offer?
$35 a head, of course.
You just bought yourself a herd. And you can tell that Maximilian that he won't find better animals between Montezuma and the Canadian border.
Just a minute.
You're selling horses to Maximilian in preference to your own country's army?
No, I'm selling horses for $35 in preference to $25. You two figured to make $10 a head.
Are you calling us thieves?
Well, Mr. Parker, yes. That's a pretty accurate description.
Wait a minute! I didn't do anything!
You should have. You should know that this is no place for a woman alone.
I will look after myself and have done so very well all my life, thank you.
I won't allow it.
Well, you do not have any say in the matter, sir.
I have a lot to say, sister. I am the federal marshal for this territory, responsible for the citizens' safety. Now, you will pack and come along with me quietly, or I'll arrest you and take you anyway.
To whom do you think you are talking, Marshal?
You is to whom I think I'm talking, sister.
It's true you are bigger than I am, but physically, that is all.
I think in this situation, that is enough.
You mean you are willing to use brute force?
That is exactly what I mean. Well, What I'm gonna give you is a 500 cow spread on the upper Green River. Now that may not seem like much. It's more than we had, your mother and I. Some folks are gonna say I'm doing all this so I can sit up in the hereafter and look down on a park named after me. Or that I was disappointed in you. Didn't want you to get all that money. But the real reason, Becky, is because I love you. And I want you and some young man to have what I had. Because all the gold in the United States Treasury, all the harp music in heaven can't equal what happens between a man and a woman with all that growing together. I can't explain it any better than that.